Let's bring it in, everybody. Our apologies to the people online. We have, it's like herding cats. Oh, man. Herding cats on YouTube. Okay. I'll do that when I get home. I'd like to call to order the business meeting of the Mike and Key Amateur Radio Club. If we could all stand and I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, everybody. Again, Ross, thank you for the presentation. That was excellent. Do we have a quorum from the Vice Secretary? All righty, thank you very much. And approval of last meeting's minutes. Does somebody want to give a mic to Jean? I think she had one thing to say as far as the minutes. Is she on for the mic?
It was brought to my attention that I had a wrong call sign associated with Daniel's name. And so Daniel and I've told him already, and that will be corrected in the minutes.
Okay, very good. Do we have a motion to pass last month's minutes?
Previously amended, yes. As amended.
Yes. Steve and Phil, second. All in favor? Can we do a poll? And those online? Good to go. 100%. All right. Thank you. At this time, we have voting for new members, and I think our vice president is out of office, so we got Manfred is going to do that. So,
hey, thank you, Carl. I'm Manfred, 87NR, and okay, so we have a number of membership applications that were approved by the board. And there are quite a few of them, and we'll see if everyone is here. First one is Marty Duke. Oh, I see. Okay. All right. Thank you. Marty Duke, WA7HOI. Marty, are you here or online? Okay, I guess not. In that case, we'll go to the next one. Jeff. Is it, let's see, Scott is bringing them up. Oh, it's Jeff Zocher, KK7NTH. Jeff, are you here online or in person? Okay. All right. Next is Jonathan Mott, KD7GAB. No? Okay.
Okay.
There's an expiration after 3 or 4, you know, month. Okay. Then we have Richard Erskine or Erskine, KK7OJZ. No? No? Still no luck?
Okay.
This will be going very fast here, I'm afraid. Then we have Ryan Bentley, KE7 Whiskey Papa Golf. Still no takers? No? Okay. All right. Barry Kelman, W7IK.
You got one.
Okay.
I'm here.
Hi, Barry. Thank you for joining us today. Would you like to say something about yourself, a little introduction?
Yeah, I'm one of the NetOps called me a regenerated ham because I actually had a tech ticket in 1962.
We still can't hear you.
Oh, boy.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, is that working now finally?
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm a regenerated ham. I actually had a tech ticket back in 1962 when I was in junior high, WA2ZXD. I let it lapse because on a $5 a week allowance, I couldn't exactly afford a decent rig. So I've gotten got back into it. I was working with John K9JEB. I was working with him on a contract. I'm a contract software developer, or used to be. I just retired last week. So I'm now officially retired and I've officially got plenty of time to play with ham radio. I got my work with John. I got the ticket back. It's about 10 years ago. And now in the last couple, 3 months, I'm really getting a lot more active in it, really liking it. Been on a couple of the nets. I think Dean knows me. And I am studying for my extra because I got in on the loophole that if you had a tech ticket prior to 1987, you just had to take the tech test to get a general. So I got my general, but now I'll have a real extra hopefully in a couple 3 weeks. That's about it. Been most, you know, on the nets. I got an Anytone 578. I also got a ICOM 7300 that I've been playing around with the FT8 a lot. And sound like to join the club, like to learn a lot more about all this stuff, all this new digital stuff, because I'm a digital guy. So that's about it.
Great. Thank you, Barry. Congratulations on your retirement. That is how I got back into ham radio too.
Yeah.
So, and I'm not the only one either, probably, you know, many others.
Yeah.
Finally, we have time, I guess. Okay. Yep. Yeah, very good. Thank you, Barry. Does anybody have any questions for Barry? Okay. In that case, we'll be voting in a short while, but we'll go through the list first and introduce everyone who's here. Next would be, see who Scott has up next. Maybe Jonathan Haynes? Yeah, Jonathan Haynes, Whiskey Zero X-Ray Oscar. Jonathan, are you here or online?
It's Saturday special.
Okay. Okay, and then we have two more. Joel Goff, KJ7SXR. Joel, are you online or in person?
Yep, I'm here online.
Oh, hi, Joel. Okay, great. Thank you for applying for membership. Would you like to introduce yourself a little bit?
Yeah, I've been a ham since the end of 2020 and upgraded to general a year after getting my tech license, and I've been really enjoying the hobby. I'm a residential electrician by trade, so that helps out with the understanding some of the stuff, and enjoyed doing FT8, and recently gotten into the satellite stuff and, you know, making contacts on the ISS and various satellites, and part of District 5 Aries here in Pierce County, and operate a couple Winlink gateways, one for HF and one for on 2 meters, bar FM, under the WA7ROY call sign for our Aries little group here in Roy, and also enjoy getting out in the field and doing some POTA and field day and helping out with Aries related events, as well as helped out with the Bigfoot 200 for a couple years now, and that's about it. Look forward to joining.
Great. Thank you, Joel. And by the way, nice to meet you in person. We had a few satellite QSOs so far. Thank you for those. It was fun. It's great. Thank you for your application. Does anybody else have a question for Joel? Okay. Carl has some.
Joel, are you going to give a presentation on how you set up your truck?
Oh, my Pathfinder? Yeah, well, I can give a presentation sometime. I don't claim to be an expert on anything, or, you know, some things are just kind of thrown together. So maybe in the future, I'll give a presentation on some of my mobile stuff and my Go Kit as well.
Thanks, Joel. Yeah, I heard you were a big draw at the free coffee event at the I-5 West Stop.
Yeah, it was good seeing Ross and others out there. And yeah, I know people were kind of interested in the, you know, porcupine rig with all the antennas. So
okay, very good. Looking forward to seeing your setup someday. Okay, stand by, Joel. We'll get to the voting at some point. So the last candidate we have today is James Edison, KK7 Papa Bravo Echo. You're here. Would you like to come up for a moment? Thank you.
I kind of wish I did this online now. So James Edison, KK7, Papa Bravo Echo. I got my ticket on Halloween, which is kind of fun because I also joined the Marine Corps in 1988 on Halloween as well. So, hoorah. So let me see. I am brand new. Assume I know nothing. I'm here to learn. And I think the story I'd like to tell about how I got involved in this was, I think back in 1977 when N7RHX asked his son and I to climb some trees and pull what I now know to be a dipole. And I just remember standing in his ham shack, which was a total disaster, but the radio section was this towering section of equipment that we were not allowed to barely even look at. Interesting. We'd really like to be a part of your team. Thanks.
Thank you, James. Congratulations on your new license, by the way. And does anybody have a question for James? Daniel?
Yes.
Yeah, field day. Field day is a good input.
Got a question.
Okay. All right. So we have three candidates to vote on, and the way that works is we have to send you out temporarily to do the voting. For Joel, you and Barry will put you in a waiting room on Zoom, and James will be escorted. Briefly. Oh, there's a question. Okay.
Yeah, I was curious why he didn't give us an address so we can't mail things to him and what have you.
Okay, well, the address, we'll get the address for records, of course, but the mailing usually gets done through email, you know, so that was...
Well, the forms that were redacted...
Oh, that too, yes.
The forms shown online were redacted due to the fact of privacy. So we got their address, but we're not going to show it on the Zoom due to privacy issues.
Thank you.
Right. Thanks, Scott. I forgot about that. Okay, very good. So I guess it is time to vote then. The first would be, Scott, would you put up the electronic vote also? For Barry Kelman, W7BIK. Okay, so online, please vote. And discussion. Okay, right. Sorry. Yes. Yes. Does anybody have anything to say about Barry? Know him personally or otherwise?
Barry.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, you did? Okay. Okay.
It's 12 chats in the chat number two, by the way.
Okay. All right. Does anybody have any comments or anything to add to Barry's application? Right. Okay. In that case, we should vote on Barry's membership first. All in favor? Looks pretty unanimous in here. Okay, and also online. Okay, that looks fine. Excellent. Next would be Joel Goff, KJ7SXR. Does anybody have any anything, Ross?
Joel.
Mm-hmm.
Joel is a great guy.
It's on.
He's helpful. He's smart. He's active, and well, like Carl said during the coffee event at the park and or the rest area.
Mm-hmm.
Joel wasn't a member, but he showed up anyhow, and he and Carl helped the guy out with a dead battery or something.
Mm-hmm.
You know, really unsolicited. And he'd just really be an asset to the organization.
Wonderful. Thank you. Okay. In that case, let's vote on Joel's membership. All in favor? Looks pretty unanimous too. And online? Okay, excellent, great. And then the third would be James Edison. Does anybody know anything about him? He's happily chatting outside. Okay. All right, if there's nothing else, let's vote on him then, all in favor. Okay, pretty unanimous too. Hey, okay, looks like we have three new club members. Please let them come in again in person or in Zoom in the chat room. Good news. Congratulations, Barry, Joel, and James. All three of you have been voted into the club, and you are now new club members, pending your payment of the dues to our treasurer, right? So once you do that, you are full members, and thank you so much for applying, and welcome to our club. Congratulations. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Manfred. Let's see what we got. I just want to reiterate the fun time that we had at the I-5 rest stop. It was good conversations, and I think it's something we should probably do on an annual basis, if not more frequently. So if we can get more participants, that would be great. I think we're... Vice President is out of office today, and I think we need Scott, our treasurer, report.
I'm up here again reminding people to pay their dues. As a result of the lack of paying dues, we lost a few members. We're now down to 293. So let's get some of those people to join and get the membership back up. Dues are available. Dues information is available online at the membership page. We accept cash, check, and online via PayPal, Square, and also Zelle. So please take care of that, and hope to see you again.
All righty. Thank you, Scott. Any other officers have anything to report? Okay. And now we get to standing committees. I think Manfred has something to say as far as membership.
Thank you, Kyle. Okay. So in case you don't know, I'm the trustee of the club who is a liaison for the membership committee. And the membership committee is usually in charge of pulling off our holiday party, which is coming up right here next month, the general meeting. Rita, KD7 CMU, has been the spear leader, you know, spearheader, however I say it, fearless leader to organize this, but she unfortunately can't make it this year. So, and I'll be out of town and travel until the day before. So in order to pull this off, make it successful, I would like to enlist a few who could help. We need to organize some sandwiches usually, or some punch type drinks, holiday type, you know, little pleasures to have. So I can show who is interested what was done before, and we can expand on that theme or change it some, you know, to whatever people feel is appropriate. But we're planning to have the holiday party here with some lunch items, basically sandwiches or something like that, at our next general meeting on, I think it is December 18th, right? Or 16th? Okay, well, the third Saturday in December in any case. But so please see me if you like to help out with that, and I very much would appreciate it. Thank you so much.
I think it's the 16th. Is that correct? It's my birthday. So I expect lots of presents, okay? No gag gifts. It will be accepted. All right. Any other standing committee reports that want to chime in? Oh, we got Daniel.
We finished the class last Saturday and all 11 passed their tests. As of now, we have 10 licenses out of 11, and one guy's on vacation. So we're looking for locations for new classes.
That reminds me, we had a class last weekend on the, I think it was 11th and 12th. Yes.
Are we still getting the free membership?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Are we on? Yeah, I will send an email out to the class members when they get all licenses. I'll have the 11th guy probably have it by Wednesday, so I'll get an email out. And also send an email to the board on that.
Yeah, I just want to mention we had a another class and test last weekend through the Renton Emergency Communication Service. Scott's team was there, and I think we had 8 out of 8, right? Yeah. Okay. So that was actually my first time teaching. So I recommend it to everybody because I actually had to study. I don't know why everybody's laughing. Yeah, Daniel.
Yeah, at our classes, we pass out the public service brochure. We go through that on repeaters and how to program your radio. We talk quite a bit about Mike and Key, by the way. And it is sponsored by Mike and Key. So,
yeah. I appreciate Daniel's dedication. Yeah, I can't thank you enough. That's appreciate it. All right, on to relay editor or webmaster. We got anybody? Mike just disappeared. So, no, he's here. He's here. Yeah, he's here. Yeah, he's taking care of coffee and donuts. Yeah, really. any of this essential committees need to report? Yes, sir. Come on, Rob.
Yeah, we have a couple of public service events coming up. The Seattle Marathon is a week from tomorrow. The communications have been a little muddled on it. I expected to hear from Franz and I didn't. I sent him an email and I didn't get a response, but then through Snohomish ACS, I got a forwarded request just Thursday night looking for hams. So they are looking for hams for that. And then the following Sunday, I believe, is the Seafarer cruise. And the information for both of those is in the booklet. You can, if you don't have the paper booklet, you can download it from the website or just go to the public service page and get the information there. So.
Thank you, Robert. Event committees, swap meet field day or picnic. Anybody got any updates for that? No? Oh, we got a field day. I'm sorry.
Basketball. I don't know if wallow in our success is the right word. So I'm happy to report in the December issue of QST Magazine, the field day results were published. Field day is not a contest, but we keep score. So what's the difference? I don't know. I think we think it's a contest. So I went through the results very carefully. I may be wrong, but I don't think I am. I'm happy to report that we were number one in our ARL section, number one in Western Washington. We were.
Yes. Yeah.
That's a big deal. So we quashed everybody on the rainy side of the state. We were number one in our class, which is six alpha, which is a huge deal. What's that? Yeah, by about, I forget, I messaged Dean, I think it was by about 1,800 points, I think it was. By 1,843 points, we were number one in six alpha, which is huge and quite an accomplishment. And then I also sort of go through all the classes and look at the scores, and as best I can tell, we were fourth out of everyone, out of all classes, even like the 12 alphas and 23 alphas, right? So that is incredible. I haven't gone back and looked at prior years, but typically we're somewhere between like 8 and 14 overall. So number 4 overall is just amazing. So I really want to thank everybody that came out for Field Day 2023. I do nothing. So I just run around and beg people for help and point out problems. So it's thanks to all of you, the collective effort that makes it happen. And I apologize, but I won't try to mention everybody because I feel like I would forget someone important. So you all know who you are, but I would encourage everyone, mark your calendars now, June 22nd, 2024, the fourth full weekend in June is the next field day. So for all of you, send the messages out to your nieces and nephews. They're not getting married that weekend. All right. They could wait. They could wait. Right. There's, June's got more than one weekend in it. So just mark your calendar. Daniel. Yes.
How
how many people participate?
That in January. But I plan on reaching out to them in December and seeing if there's hope for the barracks. So for online, the question was whether we would have barracks. Normally we have camping available and barracks available, but barracks is a question mark right now. Yes. So we do have group camping available for the whole week, included in your club, paid for by the club. So included in your membership, pay your dues. Yes, a thumbs up from the treasurer, pay your dues. It's a great deal. Yeah, Scott was thumbs up because he already did the reservation and it's prepaid and everything. It's a great deal. We'll do the week. We'll start camping midday on Monday, the Monday before field day, and be up there for the whole week. It's good fun. Radio camp is what we call it. I highly recommend if you're interested. The campground is I don't know what do you call it. It's there's no electricity. There's a pit toilet and there's water. So dry camp. Is there dry camp if there's water? It's moist camp. Yeah. Yeah, no. Anyway. Yeah. Anyway, again, I want to thank everybody for making it such a huge success. I mean, it's just phenomenal. Like I said, block your calendars for the fourth full weekend in June, June 22nd, June 23rd. Question from the back.
Sam raised his hand.
Sam, yes.
Go ahead, Sam.
There's more questions in chat.
Were there any questions about field day? Yes, in the back.
David used.
Yeah, you're on. Go.
David used to make sure he called at midnight to make sure we had our reservation for the whole park.
Oh, yeah. We've already done that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Scott took care of it for us. Yeah, we know exactly when to call and make that. But the park also knows we're coming because we've kind of been there for like the last 50 years or whatever it is. So any other questions? Manfred?
I think Mike Dinkelman noted that we were not supposed to be at CW Beach overnight. And I was one, and the park ranger suggested we should add that to our application for the next time. I was wondering if that has been done.
We haven't done the permit yet.
I see.
Yeah. So
whenever that happens, we need to not.
Yeah. Yeah. We typically do the permit, the special activity permit. We'll actually file that around May or so.
Okay. Very good. Thank you.
April, May timeframe. Okay. All right. Thanks, everyone. Were there questions or just you guys see any? Can you guys look in there and see if those chats are questions? Clicking. Primitive. Primitive. Is it primitive if it has running potable water? That's not.
It's right camp. It's right camp. It's like you take it all yourself.
Yeah.
You've got running water available. It's like a forest service camp.
And it's a big improvement.
Okay. All right. Thanks, everyone.
No. Don't applaud David. He said he did nothing. What are you applauding him for? He said he did nothing. So I don't know. Okay. Any other? Sorry. Did I echo? Okay, any other event committees? I can hear myself echo.
Back there, somebody has sound on their phone or their laptop or something.
Okay. All right. Do we have any old business that needs any attention? No. Any new business? Going once. All righty. Anything for the good of the order? Phil, come on up. I was just going to get the microphone.
So this weekend is ARRL phone sweepstakes, where you try to make contact with all the different ARRL sections. It's a lot of fun. I highly encourage you to give it a try if you're into contesting.
All right. Thank you, Phil. Any more for the good of the order? Okay. We have Don in the back. Go ahead, Don.
Yeah, Don, and I was a ham in the 70s and early 80s. I dropped out. I'm just getting ready to take a test I was a tech, so hopefully I'll use that wormhole to get my general. So quick question, though. I've got a chance to pick up a couple of Drake TR3 transceivers. Anybody in the club have a tube tester? I got a hammer. Thank you. Because I used to go to the drugstore and test your tubes. You can't do that anymore. And that's what I had. Thank you.
Somebody else have a question online? Go ahead, Mark.
Yeah, just for the good of the order, we are rebooting the Snoqualmie Emergency Communication Support Team, CCAST. So if you all want to write down our website, go check it out, secast.us, and try to hit our repeater and join the weekly directed net if you can.
Can you repeat the website again?
Yes, of course. It's Sierra Echo Charlie Alpha Sierra Tango dot Uniform Sierra. Was that helpful?
I think we got it. No. You got it, Ross? Okay.
I can chat it. I'll put it in the chat so you can see it, okay?
All right. Is there a way to get the chat recorded so we can look at that? Okay. Any more for the good of the order? And I think Don was a visitor, right? Any more visitors? Oh, go ahead. If you want to introduce yourself. Oh, wait a minute. Wait for the mic.
Hello. My name is Dave. Whiskey 7, Gulf Echo Lima. Been a ham since 2017. Helped out at the Mike and Key event down in Puyallup a couple times the last couple of years. That's been fun, seeing all the vendors and stuff and recognize a few faces here. Decided to come join the club and submit an application and go from there.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Any more visitors? All righty. Oh, we got one more. Okay.
Hi, my name's Greg, KK7 OLT. I was a ham operator in the 70s, novice out of Western New York. Joined the service, kind of put everything on hold for a while, and retired here in 2019, and just reacquired my license here in October from Scott's. Did testing with him. Like to join the club. I put an application in. Not good at public speaking, so I'm a little nervous at this kind of thing. I'm usually quiet and behind the scenes. But anyway, it'd be great to join the club. Interested in learning more about the adventures of amateur radio since the 70s. A lot has changed.
All right. Thank you very much. Anything else for the good order? Last call. All righty. Do we have a motion to adjourn at this time? Okay, Tim and Phil. All in favor? All right. Thanks everybody for attending online and in present. And Scott's got a VE session afterwards. So yeah, we'll see you next month. Come to the Christmas party.
Well, hello. Hey, do they let us chat in here anymore? I see Gary. Hi, Gary.